So then we move on to our last one, which is our weakest force. And it turns out that all molecules contain this force. Oops. All molecules possess van der Waals. Okay, so I'm just going to put van der Waals. Okay? But they don't all possess it to the same extent. What that means is that some molecules are going to have higher van der Waals and some are going to have lower. Okay? So what makes van der Waals forces increase? The very first thing and most important thing is the size, and that has to do with the molecular weight of the molecule. The higher the molecular weight, the stronger the van der Waals. Pretty easy, right? Cool. Then we've got the second most important thing, or the second indicator, is going to be the shape. Okay? The shape of the molecule. And the shape has to do with how neatly they can be arranged and how neatly they can be ordered. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to draw three different molecules, and you tell me which one would have the highest van der Waals force. So here I've got a ring that's a six-membered ring. Here I've got a six-membered chain. And then here I've got another six-membered chain. Okay? And what I want to know is, out of these three, which of them is going to have the highest van der Waals? First of all, what we would look at is the size. Are all the sizes the same? Yes, they all have six carbons. So actually, in terms of size, they're fine. Okay? Then I would look at, okay, the shape. Which one has the shape that can arrange the neatest and can stack the best? And the answer is the ring, because check it out. The ring, actually, since it's so symmetrical, it can have a bunch of rings stacked on top of each other. So if I wanted, I could keep drawing these rings stacked on top of each other. You know what that means? That there's intermolecular van der Waals forces all in between that, keeping them stuck together. Does that make sense so far? Then with the chains are still pretty good, but they're not quite as good as the rings. So here I'm drawing an example of van der Waals forces here. These are okay, but they're not quite as good as the rings. Does that make sense? And then finally, we've got the branch, which I'll try to move out of the way because I know that it's right on top of me. But with the branch, what we find is that there's not really a great way for them to stack together. They wind up kind of having a lot of space in between them. Does that make sense? So the van der Waals forces here are going to be very small compared to the van der Waals forces here for the rings. Does that make sense? Cool. So basically, I hope that this clarifies intermolecular forces. The first thing we look for is the type of force. Hydrogen bonding is the best. Van der Waals is the worst. Dipole is in the middle. And then we kind of break it down from there. Okay? So now what I want to do is do a few practice problems so you guys get comfortable with this. And I'm going to try to trick you a little bit. So be prepared, all right? Let's go.